Probably the biggest thing is the long follow-up studies that we do see, and then a little bit better understanding of kind of the what patients may benefit the most for this type of a therapy. So what's encouraging is that, you know, there have been a lot of high response rates, initial response rates, and which is what generated the initial excitement, about 80% complete response rates. While there are some early relapses that happen about 40% of the time in adult ALL patients, there are durable remissions, which is kind of what keeps the excitement going. But what we are seeing now is that those durable remissions are lasting beyond a year, not 3 years and 5 years. Those are, again, the encouraging findings. And not only that, and then we're now trying to figure out, you know, of all the patients that we do see, are there better patient set that who may benefit the most for this type of a therapy in regards to less toxicity and also kind of the more durable remissions too. So the patients with a lower burden disease are the ones that do stand out and do want to be the kind of the most beneficial group. So that's kind of the one thing we're learning. And then subsequently, there are ongoing trials. There's about to, they're beginning now to investigate to reduce the toxicity of CD19 CAR T cells in ALL to not only manage them, so which we are getting much better at than previously, so it's much more manageable toxicities, but we want to prevent them completely from occurring without compromising the efficacy. So some of those approaches targeting different cytokines specifically are ongoing now.